I'm going to talk to you a little bit about some of the tools that we have at our disposal to assess in-season nutrient status. And of course, we're all pretty familiar with walking fields and identifying situations where maybe that crop is a little bit light colored, doesn't look quite right. And one of the tools that you have is our Yara Check It app. And this is an excellent tool for you to have just to kind of get a sense of what a nitrogen deficiency might look like in that cereal crop, or phosphorus, or potassium. You know, a lot of times the crop is going to give us an indication of crisis levels when it comes to a nutrient deficiency. But probably the greatest opportunity for us as advisors, as agronomists, as farmers, is in this area where the crop really isn't exhibiting visual symptomology. It's in this hidden hunger range. And one of the ways that we can assess that is through the use of tissue tests. And I've got an example here of one. This is one of our Mega Labs report. This happens to be for canola field, but just to give you an idea of kind of what it looks like, our nutrients, and then kind of where they're at and whether or not we're deficient or sufficient or whatever, can be an excellent way for us to become a little bit more prescriptive in season when it comes to the deployment of a specific nutrient to address a specific problem, whether that's boron or whether it's potassium or copper or what have you. And I wanted to take just a minute and kind of walk you through the process of taking a tissue test. Nothing to be intimidated by. It's really quite straightforward. Of course, anytime we're doing sampling, we want to try to choose a part of the field or parts of the field that are representative. You know, I have had situation where guys have went in and chosen the very worst part of the field and the very best part of the field to kind of get a sense of what's going on. And that's for sure an excellent way to approach tissue testing. But oftentimes what I'm looking for is what's going on in the predominant part of the field. In the part of the field where the bulk of my bushels are coming from, what's the nutrient status there? So what I will do is pick probably, 12 spots within that predominant zone, and then try to collect about a good softball size worth of biomass. And you want to be careful that you're not creating any kind of contamination. You know, I have had situations where guys will just come in and rip the plants up. But boy, there's a good chance that you're going to get dirt in your sample, and that's going to actually cause some problems when it comes to the interpretation of that. You know, we've got lots of iron, lots of nutrients that is in that soil that we don't want in the plant material when we're setting it in. And you want to refer to the various lab guides in terms of what crop, based on the crop stage, what part of the plant you're going to be taking. Bottom line, when that crop is new and fairly young, we're taking a whole plant. As that crop gets bigger, oftentimes we take the newest leaf. But you always want to look and see, because the lab interprets those results based on a specific plant part. So for this particular wheat crop, we're going to say we're just going to go ahead and take the whole plant. And I would just come in and bring my scissors and just kind of trim that fairly close. Again, trying to be careful that I'm not getting dirt in that sample. And then put that right in my sample bag. And I usually kind of wad that up and put it in there, and then walk to another part of the field and grab another sample. Probably should be either very clean hands, or you know, I've even brought surgical gloves so you're not contaminating it with sweat or whatever on your hands, to try to get a good representative sample. And then once I've got enough mass there, typically I'll just kind of leave this open, set them on my dash as I'm wandering around the rest of the day doing my soil tests, and then try to get them shipped off, usually overnight, and anticipate I should have results within a week. I usually am trying to position tissue tests as more of a tool for me to understand how this crop is taking up nutrients, and use that as part of my analytical data set, soil tests, what that grower has applied for fertility, all that kind of gives us a unique insight into what's going on in a field for soil nutrient uptake. So.